written word is a beautiful thing. It represents the evolution of the human race. Although, marking some of your work, you would hardly think that that was the case. Excellent.
Oh, Daddy's little girl.
And that, Mr. Knight, is fantastic. If you're in the first year of primary school, perhaps you'd feel a little happier with a box of crayons colouring in pictures of little kittens. Are you going somewhere, mister?
Oh! How are you feeling?
Fine. I think I'll be ready to come back next week.
Yes, it must have been a horrible ordeal.
The reason that we asked you here, Robert, is that we're very keen to see if we can resolve this issue without...
unnecessary legal complications.
I think I'm right in saying that Philip Knight leaves at the end of this year, and there's only 3 months till the end of term, so with that in mind, I think we should be able to come to some satisfactory compromise with Philip and his parents.
You're not thinking of letting that boy back in my classroom, are you?
I'm not sure you understand the situation, Mr. Anderson. The parents of the boy in question are threatening to sue you personally.
And the school.
Now, I'm sure you're aware that giving the students Fs has long been against national guidelines.
It was a fail, Sarah. It was barely even literate.
R.S. Resubmission. That's how you're required to label the piece. Robert, giving a student an F is just felt to be humiliating for the child.
And Mrs. Knight feels that you provoked Philip into attacking you by belittling her child's academic performance in front of the other children.
This is my fault.
No, we're very keen not to assign blame here, Mr. Anderson.
All we're suggesting is that you take extended leave until the end of term, after which point Philip will have left, and then we will, of course, welcome you back with open arms. Rob, please, Robert, can you... I am so sorry.
Sorry. Didn't mean to startle you.
No, you didn't. You look very nice.
Thank you. Boiler broke this morning. Couldn't even have a shower.
Oh, right. I'll pop over tonight.
No. You don't have to. I'll call a plumber. No, it's really not your speciality. Plumbing.
I'll take a look, right? It's not a problem.
Okay. Thank you. I just wanted to have a chat with you about next weekend. I know it's your weekend with Kate, but,
Helen, you don't have to worry.
I don't?
No, I haven't forgotten our daughter's birthday.
No.
That's all right. I'm going to take her to the theatre. You could come if you like.
Oh, that sounds really nice, but she asked me to ask you if you wouldn't mind if she went to London with some friends to see a band.
Right.
I'm sure she'll ask you herself.
So there's going to be an adult with them, yeah?
Oh, Robert, you know, she's 16 years old.
I'll think about it. I have to go.
You looking after yourself? You look tired.
It's a busy time of the year.
Yeah, of course. Of course. Don't be too hard on Katie. Please? So I'll see you tonight.
Good luck.
Do we have any books about plumbing in the library?
Possibly.
Good.
Come in. Robert, please, take a seat. So, how are things?
Good, fine.
That's great. And how's it going with the Year 12s?
Fine.
I still seem to be missing some assessment grades for them.
Yeah, sorry, I haven't sent those over. I'll do that.
Well, I know that this time of year is always a bit of a pain, but I really am going to need them. I hope that's okay.
Yeah, of course, I'm really sorry. Let's see. I think I've almost done everything. It won't take me 5 minutes.
Thanks, Robert. Just one other thing before you go. Some of the teachers have raised their concerns about the noise level coming from your class.
Well, all right, I'll get them to keep it down.
Yes. It's probably nothing. I mean, you know how some people can get it. But I think it was more about the actual language being used by the students. Robert.
I'll keep an eye on it.
Thanks, Robert. I appreciate that. Just one other thing. It's probably nothing. Crossed wires or something, but there's been a complaint about you bringing in alcohol to the premises.
Well, I cannot think what that's about.
I know. It's probably, as I said, just crossed wires. I know that you would never do such a thing. Because it would mean suspension.
Exactly.
Thanks, Robert. I think I might pop into your class tomorrow. Is that okay? It's nothing to be concerned about. I'm just going to sit at the back and observe for a few minutes.
Of course.
Thanks, Robert. And Robert, please never send a memo like that across the staff network again without consulting me first.
He stinks.
Hold it up. You look shit. Nice memo, by the way.
But how we perceive ourselves may not be how we are perceived by others. Leah believes himself to be a good and responsible monarch. However, Goneril, Legion, and Fool constantly remind him that he is a man who has lost his kingdom, his faithful daughter, and his wits through his own this is shown. For an hour's detention each night for a week, starting tonight.
Anything going on?
Not really.
What's this?
It's a memo from Anderson. He sent it out to all members of staff.
Did you know there were nearly 7,000 recorded violent incidents affecting teachers, janitors, dinner ladies and cleaners last year? Is he for real? What's he want us to do? Start installing gun detectors and searching kids' bags?
I don't know.
Cars are not bad.
Well, I'm going for a smoke.
I'll start locking up the gates.
Yeah, all right.
Hey, what do you think you're doing? Put the phone away. I give this to your mother when I see her tonight.
That's so unfair.
Kate, unfair is when something happens for no reason.
This is bullshit. You're bullshit. You're a pathetic man who has to put his daughter in detention in order just to spend time with her.
Please, Kate, that's enough.
And who's so afraid of his students that he has to drink a bottle of whiskey before he can even step in a classroom.
Please, just sit down.
No! Our lives are better off without you. You know, Mum said she'd rather be alone forever than get back together with you.
Hey! Let me out of here!
trouble!
Hey, Jake, it's me. No, I'm using the phone in reception. Can you come and pick me up? Just come and pick me up. Jake? Jake? The phone's not working. That's it.
I'm sure the phone company will fix it soon.
Come on, damn you, bruise.
What is it?
There's someone out there.
I don't see anyone.
No, there was someone watching me. I swear, I saw someone.
You're Mr. Anderson's girl, aren't you?
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Mr. Anderson. How can I help you?
I think there were kids inside the building.
It is a school.
One of them threw something against the window as I was walking down the corridor.
Threw what?
A milkshake.
A milkshake?
Jesus, what are you, a parrot? Yes, a milkshake.
What flavour?
I'm glad that you find this amusing.
What do you want me to do about it, Mr. Anderson?
I'd like you to do your job instead of sitting here all night looking at pictures of naked men.
It's a fitness magazine.
Fantastic.
Whereabouts?
E-block corridor.
You and your daughter are as bad as each other.
You've seen my daughter?
Yeah, she was here 10 minutes ago.
Why?
She wanted to use a phone, but the lines are down.
Since when?
Half an hour ago.
And this doesn't worry you?
No, Mr. Anderson, it doesn't.
So where was she going?
Back into the school. Maybe she's the one that threw the milkshake. What are you doing?
What do you think I'm doing? I'm calling the police.
Calm down, Mr. Anderson. Look, I'll sort this out and you go and find your daughter, yeah? And the police are hardly going to come out of here over a spilt milkshake, are they?
I tell you, if I catch you little brats, you're gonna have hell to pay!
After your plumbing books?
Oh. Have you seen my daughter?
Kate? The last time I saw her in the library was about a year ago. Something up?
Well, we just had a bit of an argument, that's all, and then she stormed off.
She's probably in the girls' toilets having a cigarette and sulking.
No, she doesn't smoke.
Of course she doesn't. It'll be fine. Why don't you wait here, keep me company while I finish up? I know teenage girls. Give her a chance to calm down and then she'll come looking for you.
No, I think I'd better find her. You see, I think there are kids inside the building. The phones, they've all stopped working. You should leave.
Okay, where are you going?
I need to find my daughter and you should leave now.
Right. Robert? Unbelievable. You think that's funny? Some of you children don't deserve to be in school. We'll see how funny you think this is when you have to explain it to your parents. You are in so much trouble.
The shit out of me.
I was waiting for you outside.
Yeah, some creepy guy was watching me. But I wasn't expecting you for ages.
Kate, are you in there? Kate? I can smell smoke. Kate, if you are in there, please, darling, we have to leave now. We won't say anything more about what happened earlier because I know you were just upset and I was very, I was very tough on you. But please, Kate, we have to go now. Right. I'm coming in.
Robert! What on earth are you doing?
I have to find my daughter.
Well, I'm sure if she's in the toilet, then you might want to let her finish.
But we have to leave now. I think we might be under attack.
And why would you think we're under attack, Robin?
The phone lines have been cut.
Cut?
Yes, they're not working.
Well, maybe one of the lines is down. The phone company's probably fixing them as we speak.
Right. I was walking down the corridor, and then someone threw something at the glass. I think it was a milkshake or something, and then they wrote in it, "You're dead!"
Jake Peoples, I might have known. Well, he's your culprit, Mr. Anderson. Come on. Right, Kate, you go home with your father. We'll let him deal with you, and we'll deal with you on Monday morning. My father hit me. Sorry? My father hit me. Is this true?
This has got nothing to do with the school.
Right. Go home now. I'll deal with you later. Now! You need to come with me. We need to phone your mother.
That's not necessary.
Go home, Robert.
Please, Sarah.
Listen, this is very serious, Robert. I said go home.
Kate.
Listen. Don't make me call security. Have some dignity.
Thank you. Hello? Hello? James, you scared me.
Sorry, Miss Wright. I just saw the light on. Yeah, Mr. Anderson was worried about some kids running around. He asked me to check it out.
Right. Well, there's no one in here now. Hello? Is there someone there? Look, if this is some kind of joke, I don't think it's...
Please don't hurt me. Yeah.
do realize these are very serious allegations you're making. I need you to write down exactly what happened. I'm gonna call your mother, so you can go into the staff room and use the desk there.
I can see you're doing fuck all, Dad.
Hi, James, it's Sarah. Oh, my phone's not working. Okay, thanks, James. Just one other thing. It's a bit of a sensitive issue, but there's been a bit of an incident between Mr. Anderson and his daughter, and I've had to ask him to leave the premises. So could you just make sure that he won't come back in? I really think his state of mind's fragile at the moment.
Hello?
Mrs. Anderson?
Yes?
It's Sarah Ballam here from Wittering College. I'm afraid there's been a bit of an
incident here.
Is Kate okay?
No,
your daughter's fine, Mrs. Anderson. She's next door. However, she has made a serious complaint about your husband. And I think it's best if you come and collect her.
What are you talking about? What? Is she all right?
No, she's fine. She's a bit shaken, but I really think it is best that you come and collect her.
Yes, of course. I'll be there in 20 minutes.
Well, we shall meet you down at reception.
Fine.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Kate?
No.
It's Robert. Listen, Alan, something's wrong.
What the hell is going on, Robert?
Sarah Ballam just called and told me
that you hit Kate. Is that true?
It wasn't like that.
What was it like, Robert?
I'm sorry, Helen. I can't talk to you about it now.
No, listen, don't you dare. I need to know what happened.
Helen, call the police.
Robert?
Robert?
Thank you. messing around here?
There's someone out there. They have knives. They were chasing me.
You almost got me. I bet you pull that stunt with your father all the time.
I'm telling you the truth.
Have you been drinking? Are you on drugs?
You need to call the police.
You kids will see anything. Friend of yours? You better stay put.
Don't go out there. I'm telling you, they have knives.
I've had it with you fucking kids!
right, Brian. I've just had Mrs. Ballam on the phone. She says Anderson has ended up hitting his own daughter. She wants me to take him off the bridge.
Whoa! I need to find my daughter.
Right, that's it, you crazy old man. Brian!
They've killed Sarah.
Yeah, of course they have. Look, why don't you explain that to the police when they get here, eh?
Look at the screen. Please, just look at the damn screen! I've already called the police, they're on their way. Where is this?
That's F Block, it's the art studio. Wait, Sarah told me to call the police when I saw you.
Sarah is dead.
I just spoke to her on the phone.
Then speak to her again.
Mrs. Ballam,
we're sorry. The number you've dialed is not in service at this time.
Now, would you help me find my daughter?
Brian? Brian, are you reading me, mate?
I always told her to memorize where the cameras were so she could be seen. Just in case. Kate! Fuck's sake, man, they'll hear you! Kate!
Please, just leave us alone, yeah?
Do you want to go around the side of the building, check if things are okay?
Sure.
Let's see if I can locate that waste of space security guard.
What's going on?
You gotta help me get out of here! I've got to get out of here!
Calm down!
Let me go, man! You gotta let me go!
What's wrong with you?
You've got to get out of here! You gotta help me get out of here!
What's going on? What's the matter with you? I'm warning you!
Dad?
Oh. Oh, my baby. It's all right. It's all right. I'm so sorry.
I'll hate you forever. Hello? Is there somebody there?
La, la, la. Love.